Welcome everyone. Thanks for the overwhelming response shown to our webinar series we are conducting. Manupatra is currently celebrating its 20th year of operations. And we are happy that Manupatra is known as a research tool and not just a tool to put citations and take printouts. Now I will show you the features of our site, and at the end we can have a Q&A session. So for that, I'll be logging in to our website. So today I will be talking to you about Manupatra search. We have four types of searches. One is Manu search, legal search, citation search, and SSH search. SSH search is a new search type what we have introduced. It is youngest of the lot. In Manu search, we use natural language processing and Boolean parameters like and, or, not to search. So I'll just show you an example. So I want to use asterisk. You can use this for vegetation right or rights, both. You want to search and just make a search. So I've got some 3638 results, which you can see on the right hand side. We have an option here to filter it by what others who have searched earlier on visitation rights and what were their filter terms. So just click here, I get various options. I can use this, or I can go to search and results and click on this and define it. I can refine it multiple times. I'm using here the Boolean operators. So it has filtered from 3000 odd results to 600 results. So you can also change your query or refine it or by clicking on these plus signs, cross signs. I do not want the word father. I want to reframe it. I want to do a negative keyword search. Basically, what will happen is it will delete that particular word from the search results. So it's giving me 538 results. You want to add, you can also add the words from here. So I have clicked on one of the keywords from the option given below. So I'll show you some other options. The most common query what we get is, how do you search for order and rule, like civil procedure code order 6 rule 17? How do I search that? You can search it through legal search, or you can also search it through Manu search. So what parameter I use here is a proximity thing, which is ordered proximity. You use @ for ordered proximity, put those words in double inverted quotes, and the number of words you want all those words to come in. So I'm putting 10 here and clicking on search. I've got various results. So I want to filter it to Delhi High Court judgments. So I can click on that. And I want to look at this judgment. So you can click on this and open the judgment. To go back to the results, which is one of the most common queries, when I open the judgment in the same window, you have option to click on back to results, or you have a floating window where you can go back to the results from this icon, or you can click on results on the top, which will take you back to the results page. Or you can open your judgments clicking on the additional window icon. I would like to mention here, this is one of the new features what we have introduced. You can see a Supreme Court icon here. This mentions there is a SLP pending in Supreme Court. If you open the judgment, you can go there and see the SLP filed. I'm not explaining that feature because that has been explained in another webinar already. So this is how you search on Manu search. If you have any doubts, you can use search tips. Next to the search icon, you have search tips. We have given the search type, description, and examples. Coming to legal search. In legal search, by default, the tab is on advanced search. Other tabs are also available, like citation, international act, and all. So I would like to show you various examples in legal search, starting with Act search. I want to search for NI Act, Section 138, and CRPC, Section 200. So I click on search. I get various results. We have 1,558 results. So no one would be interested in seeing these many results. So you want to sort it, filter it. All those options are available, which I'd like to show you. By default, it is on relevance. Then you have an option to click on sort by court name, decision date, which is the chronological order, or a title, or most cited. If I click on most cited, I get the most cited judgment on the query. You can see below the judgment, you have the count, how many times this case has been cited in other cases. Then we have filters. You can filter it by quote. You can filter it by keywords. And click on any keyword here. Next to the keyword, you can also see the number of judgments you have for that particular keyword. Then you can filter it by judge, period, document type, industry type. This is one of the features which none of the tools give, apart from Anupatra, where you would like to see, I'm working in a corporate. I work for a particular industry, so I want to see judgments from that industry instead of looking for any other industry judgments, because these judgments would be similar to my situation. So these are the judgments on agriculture and agro products. So then you have publisher filter. All the publishers are mentioned here. Then you have judge bench filter. A three bench has 13 judgments. You can want to read that. You can click on that. So there are various options what you have. On the top, you can see save search option. So you type in anything here and click on save. This search gets saved. This option is not to retrieve the search results back, but to, I've already done this save search. So I go to manage search. So I have on the top this NI and CRPC. I can select number of days I want the alerts to come to me. Like today I have made a search. From this time onwards, if there is any new judgment uploaded on Manupatra on the same query, we will send you an alert. You don't have to repeat this search again and again. So for this, you'll have to click on this pencil icon, type in your email ID, select the alert and select the number of days. So you would be setting an alert and getting alerts for next 45 days. That's a maximum what you can do. You can keep renewing as many times you want it. Then you have an option to select head notes here. So instead of opening the judgment, you can read the head notes here itself in the search screen. Or I do not want all head notes. I have a icon here which comes on all the judgments, which is called Manu Instant. If you click on this, you will get the brief of that judgment, like Manupatra citation, date of decision, subject, citing reference, acts rules referred, prior history of the case, and head note of the judgment. So this is for one single judgment. If you want menu instance for all the judgments, click on see all. So you'll get a list of all. You can take a printout of menu instance. Then how do I open the judgment? You have three options for that. One is click on the title, as I showed you earlier in one of the judgments. Second is click on the window icon to open an additional window. So the search remains as it is, or click on toggle view. If you click on this, the screen gets divided into two. On the top you have the search result and down you have the judgment. Then you have another icon here called add to session. This icon you can correlate with add to cart in e-commerce sites. Usually what you do, shortlist what you want to purchase. The same way here, you shortlist the judgments before you want to take a printout or you want to mail it to yourself or save it on your desktop. So I click on add to session. Before signing off, I need to go to the session list. Here I have a list of all the judgments I have clicked on add to session. I can select which all judgments I want. I can email it, save it, or print it. All judgments can be done at one shot. So you don't have to mail each and every judgment. You just select all you want to send and then click on the icon above. This is add to session. So now I'd like to show you how a typical judgment looks like on Manupatra. You have Manupatra citation on the top left. If I click on that citation, I get all equivalent citations where all this judgment has been mentioned. So that's our option. To view equivalent citations, you have a library, you want to read it from the books, you take down the citation what you have and you can go to the books and read it there or read it in Manupatra. Next to the Manupatra citation, there's an icon. If you click on that icon, it will show you how this judgment was treated when it was referred in other cases. This judgment, you can see, has been cited in 625 cases. So you can see the treatment of this case. 50 times out of 625, it was discussed, 35 mentioned, 11% relied, 2% distinguished, 1% affirmed, and 1% dissented. So this will help you to understand how it was treated. It is very much required to know how the judgment was treated when it was cited in by others. So nowadays you don't even watch a movie without seeing the rating of that movie. So why cite a judgment without knowing how it was treated when it was cited? So you have various icons on the right hand side on the top right of the judgment. I'm not covering those, but I would suggest you go through the other webinars. We also have, if you have missed any of the webinars, you can go to YouTube and click Manupatra webinars and view our webinars which have been conducted earlier. Next to the icons, you have print replica. Print replica is nothing but the same judgment published in any other journal. Wherever we have a tie-up with the journal, we give you a scan copy of the. So this can be downloaded, printed. If you want to submit a journal copy, you can use this. You have another journal, what we have, the same judgment. Then we also give you the code copy, which is Judas, the same, which is on the Judas NIC website. So this is print replica. Then you could see the case numbers, date of judgment, party names. Then you can see judge names, counsels who have appeared. You can see all these are hyperlinked. If you click on anything, it takes you to a search result of that particular word. Then you have counsels, then you have subject, catchwords, the keywords of the judgment, mentioned in, which would show you where all this case has been mentioned in. As I showed you, 625 cases has been mentioned in. If I click on that mentioned in, it will take me to all those 625 cases. Then you have acts and rules. Then you have cases referred. Cases referred are all hyperlinked. You can click on any of these and go to that judgment if you want to read it. Then you have prior history of the case. This case has come from which High Court to Supreme Court. You can click on that hyperlink to view the judgment. Then you have the disposition where is written appeal allowed. Then you have citing references. The judgments which have been cited in this case, I want to see which are the cases affirmed here. So I can view those cases and which are the cases which have been relied. You can see from which courts they are from. Relied, affirmed, all that also you can view. Then comes the summary of the judgment, which is called the case note or head note. After the summary, you have the full text of each judgment. So in the judgment, three of the catchwords are highlighted and the act and sections are also highlighted. If I click on this particular section, it takes me to act. I can go to the digest and I can also go to the judgments if I want to view judgments from that particular section. Can also view the commentary here for few specific important acts. We have the commentary. You can read the commentary. These are from renowned authors. So this is how a typical judgment look like. Another option what you have is if you want to view a Google translate of this judgment. If I want to translate the judgment, I can translate it to any other language. So now we take you back to legal search. Let me show you one of the party searches. I want to search for United Breweries versus State Bank of India. So I've just typed in United Breweries and State Bank. So it does a proximity search and it will give you a result where both these are parties. So I've got the result on the top. I can click on that and open the judgment. So this is about party search. Let me search. For example, you have to search for the current CJA, and I want to search for on Constitution of India. What all judgments Justice Bobde has given? So you have the list of judgments here. So you have a case before a particular judge. I want to see all those cases. I have this option. This would give you all the judgments. See, you can see the subject is criminal, but one of the acts referred here is Constitution of India. So if I want subject as Constitution, I can select judge and say select Constitution as a subject. So I'll get only judgments where the decision is taken by Justice Bobde and the subject of that judgment is Constitution. So in legal search, you have multiple options. You can fill in what all information you know so that the results can be minimized. So as I'm showing you various examples, then we have this case category for Supreme Court cases, where Supreme Court, they themselves categorize the cases. We are giving you those options. I can select any category and click on search. So I get the judgments on that particular category. On the top, I showed you search by NI Act and CRPC. Now down we have another act search where the relevancy of that section and act is there. Basically, the judgment has been decided on that particular act and section. Let me try out . So I want to search for Constitution of India Article 265. So I've got some 18 results Let me open the first result, which is Mafaflal Industries versus Union of India. So you can see the relevant section of this particular judgment is Constitution of India, Article 265. All other things remain the same as I have explained you. Let me show you one example where a case is overruled. I have searched for Konkan Railway, and you can see on the top, when I get a search result, I get this icon of red flag, which shows the case Konkan Railway versus Rani Construction has been overruled. Which judgment has overruled this? You can click on the flag and open that judgment. SVP and Company versus Patel Engineering has overruled that case. So you can view that judgment from here itself. So I have showed you Manu search and legal search. Let me now show you SHH search, which is very much similar. And as I told you in the beginning, this is a new search type what we have introduced. If I have to show you the same example, what I showed you in Manu search. So I want to search for visitation right or rights. I have used various filters. I can put them all in this same place. If you want either of the words or negative keyword and all, that also can be done here. If I want minor as a negative keyword, I can put that also here. I also put in father. So I will make a search. So this will search for judgments which has all of these words, and it will delete all the judgments which has the word minor. If I want, I can filter it to the any court I am interested in. So SHH search is similar to what Manu search is. The only difference here is you don't have to use any parameters, what Boolean characters we showed you. You just have to type in any of these blanks what we have given as an option. Then the last search what we have is citation search. So let me show you an example. I have a citation of MLJ, Madras Law Journal, 2019, volume 8, page number 117. So I directly click on search. I go to that result. Let me show you another example using Manupatra citation. Let me do that by putting the citation first and then do this. I actually put the page number first, so it would filter it as per the year. If you type the page number first, you might have the similar page on many other years. So you have the searches, what I have shown you till now. This was the last search, what was supposed to show you. Let me show you that search again. So I have not selected the court, but as I want to go for Supreme Court this judgment, I can select there directly and go for that particular judgment. So to summarize what all I have explained you in this, to start with, I showed you the types of searches: Manu, legal, citation, and assisted search. Then I have showed you the various options to filter. You can filter it by court, keyword, judge, period, document type, industry type, publisher, and judge bench. I have also showed you sort by title, chronological order, court, and most cited. I have showed you Manu Instant, which is the brief of the judgment in the search result. I also showed you Save Search. Then I have showed you an option where you can add to session. I have showed you the multiple options what we have to open a judgment. I have then explained you how a typical Manupatra judgment would look like, what features are there in that, like Manu citation, Manu cite, print replica, citing reference, hyperlinking of judgments cited and acts. So these are the things what I have explained you. So I would now be open for the Q&A session. You have any queries, you can ask me. Hello? Hello? Yeah, tell me. You can ask your question. Hello. Your voice is not audible. You have any query, you can mail us on contact@manupatra.com. Anyone else who has a query? Yeah.
Can you hear me?
Yeah, I can hear you.
Can you show me one second.
Let me mute. Yes, tell me.
I citation, which is Manu,
which is Manu slash
/4/2020.
You want me to show how to search for this?
I want you to show me this citation /NC/08/84/2020.
So I'll just show you. See, I showed you the last example. It's Manu SE is a code, then you have the page number, then the year. First is Manu, then the code, then the page number, then the year.
But I don't know the publisher in this.
Publisher? Manu. If it is Manu, it should be Manu Patra. Hello? Hello, Yogita? Hello? Hello?
Hello.
Yeah.
Yeah. Can you please explain how to open judgment in another window?
So next to the search.
Huh.
If I go to any search, let me show you. I had searched for Konkan Railways. You have this window icon on the right hand side.
Yes. Yes.
Click on that. Okay. You can open as many windows you want. Okay, thank you so much. Thanks a lot. Yeah, Mr. Pawan.
Hello.
Hello. Yeah, Mr. Pawan, tell me.
Normally, in the Act, there is always a preamble and the history, the Parliament, the background legislation before passing any Act. Is there a law, sort of a history is available in the Manu Patra? Can we get to know rationale behind passing any Act?
Yes. If you go to the Act, in the Bare Acts, on the left-hand side of the Manu Patra TOC.
Okay.
You go to the Bare Acts. You have this brief facts, right? Click on that icon. You have the statement of objective mentioned there.
Okay.
This is a place you can view that.
Can you show me again? Can you show me again from where you got this? Aadhaar.
Go to the Bare Acts.
Okay.
On the left hand side in the TOC. Select any category you want. Click on brief facts icon.
Okay. So there you capture the entire history or just a part of that? It's a brief way or it's the...
That icon, you get only the objective, how many times the Act is amended, whether the Act is fully active or effective or partially effective, all those things. It's a brief. Then you click on the Act and you can get the complete Act.
Act, I understand. The preamble is already there in the Act itself, but I want to know the entire Parliament, either any committee behind any rationale.
That you have to go to the Bills in Parliament.
Okay.
Okay. But
for example, sometimes we have interpretation issues, so we want to know what the rationale behind passing this Act. So they always.
I have shown you the objective of that particular Act.
Okay.
So that is what it is. So, if you want more information, go to the Bills in Parliament. Okay?
Okay.
Thank you. Hello? Hello.
Can you once again show from the left side there's tribunals and commissions? Can you show me NCLT cases? You can see from left side there's tribunals and commissions.
Yes. Yes, here are the cases. What do you want to do here? Hello.
Yes, NCLT.
Yes.
Then how to go about it?
You have to make a search. You can't view any of the judgments clicking on this. You'll have to go to search and
legal.
Search for it.
Okay.
If say Companies Act, you type whatever results you get, you'll get from Supreme Court or High Court. You want only NCLT, you just select this and then type Companies Act.
Okay. So this is to filter your result. Okay.
Yes, you can select and then search, or search and then select. As I showed you the filters, you add a code filter there.
Mm-hmm.
You can filter it with that also. Okay.
And when I was trying to search that citation, there were no results. But on 14th, when I tried it, the judgment came today. It's not coming.
Your voice is not very clear. Can you be?
I will type out.
Yeah. Thank you. Anyone else? You have any queries? Please mail it to us at contact@manupatra.com. Thanks a lot for your time. Hope to see you in our future webinars, and happy researching.